Good morning, everyone. This is Dr. Swati Mishra from International School of Business Management at Suresh Gandhi University, Jaipur. And we are studying service marketing. Service marketing being a very important subject of marketing stream becomes one of the most sought after professions today, and service marketeers become one of the most sought after professionals of today's world. And that is why I have taken this course, because it is a very interesting course to be studied by all the people who aspire to make their careers in marketing. And as we have proceeded through our sessions of service marketing, I have introduced you to service marketing in the first unit. I also discussed some important aspects and introductory concepts of service marketing. Further, as we move ahead and we reach the second unit, we started discussing some deeper concepts of service marketing, wherein we got introduced to the concept of internal customers and internal marketing. So this session basically aims at, you know, understanding as to what is, I've already explained you the concept of internal customers. Now we will be studying that what is, you know, the difference between this internal versus the external customers. So we will be, you know, discussing some important aspects here. The learning objectives of today's session are to give the learners knowledge about the difference between the internal customers and the external customers. The learners will get an understanding of, you know, the difference between the internal customers and the external. We'll get an understanding of whether the negative internal customer experiences affect the external customers also. The main objective of this session is to understand the drawbacks of making each person a customer. As far as the learning outcomes of this session are concerned, after this session, the learners will carry the knowledge about the difference between internal customers and external customers. The learners will have the awareness of whether negative internal customer experiences affect the external customers also. And the outcome of this session will be the understanding of the drawbacks of making each person a customer. So let us try to move ahead now, and we will be discussing some further important aspects of this concept of internal customers and external customers. But before we move ahead, the first thing that we need to understand is the main difference between the internal and the external customers. So what we need to do is we need to understand that whether, you know, there is any difference between internal customers and external customers. And if yes, then how these internal and external customers are different from each other. We'll be starting in a while. Just give me a second. So let us move ahead and discuss some of the main differences of internal versus the external customers. Basically, as far as our internal and external customers are concerned, the internal customers, as you clearly know now, after two sessions of understanding the internal customers and the concept of internal marketing, the internal customers are the stakeholders of the industry, like the employees, the owners, the representatives, the suppliers, and the other stakeholders of the company. And, you know, the external customers are the external members of the organizations which are somehow related to the organization. They could be the main customers of the organization, the suppliers of the organization, the society in general at a large, where the organization actually flourishes and functions, the governments which are holding any kind of power on the organization, the creditors of the organization, the shareholders of the organization. So these are the external members or the external customers of the organization. So let's once again try to brush up. We have clearly understood what are internal customers. Now once let's try to understand what are internal customers. I mean external customers. We have discussed what are internal. We have to discuss external now. So external customers are basically all the people or all the members that pay for the use of the products or the services of any company, whatever a company is offering. So whenever you are trying to brainstorm any problem, design any sort of solutions, you know, these are the customers who are actually whom you are designing for. Or these are the customers for whom actually you are brainstorming and coming up with a new product or a product idea or a service to be provided, right? So whatever an organization is actually producing so that it can earn revenue from it, so that it is doing for these customers. So to be absolutely clear, you know, an external customer should be taken as a person who is not directly connected to your organization, which means he's not an employee of your organization, other than by purchasing your product or service. He's taking your product or service, right? So this customer could be a one-time purchaser, or maybe a person who has worked for a long duration of time with you people and to whom you have provided multiple add-ons and customization options also. And these external customers are actually, you know, also known as clients by the organization or maybe accounts by the organization. So whenever an organization is trying to set some goals for, you know, these external customers, to achieve a huge external customer base, to create them, you know, to keep your external customers happy, to create a loyalty within these customers, then the goals for your external customers can depend on your product or the service, which means, you know, repeat purchasing, referrals which they give, positive reviews that they gave, and otherwise, you know, supporting your company also. So you might follow up an after purchase also of your company. You might follow up, you know, during the purchase of the company, the product of the company. And sometimes you may just follow them up for, you know, a formal or a quick pulse survey. So, you know, every organization is having some kind of rule about the customers. Mostly, most of the organizations believe that the customer is always right. This is a general guiding principle that organizations have while serving this customer group, external customer group. And the revenue they generate is the life and blood of your company. they also believe that without them, your company is going to fail, right? So that is what an external customer is for an organization. It is the life and blood of the organization. It is the one whom an organization is considering always right. And it is the one around whom, around whose satisfaction the entire company's working procedures, ideas, the implementation of ideas actually is taking place. So that is the importance of a customer for an organization. Now let us just try to compare your internal customer with the external customer. So, you know, this external customers have been inherent in businesses ever since the people started making and selling the products for a long time. So the idea of an internal customer, however, is a more modern one. For instance, say Six Sigma, you know, it encourages identifying internal customers as a way of creating a more positive work environment. And a more positive work environment would lead to better productivity and better efficiency, ultimately increasing the organization's productivity and revenue, and of course, the quality of the services that are being rendered by the company. So this positive work environment actually includes different things like kind and empathetic leadership, fair and equitable pay, comfortable working environment, imbibement of the latest technology in your organization, safe work culture for females, safe and respectable work culture for the females. So there could be so many things that a positive environment would include. And there is a thinking or an understanding which goes like, you know, that the higher morals of the employees, the more those employees will work with integrity and the more productivity they are going to generate. So that morale can also come from the idea that they are contributing to something larger. So they have to be made to feel this. You have to make your employees realize that you are working on creating a repo of this organization. It is because of you that this organization is existing. It is because of you that this organization is flourishing. So this is what ripples out positivity, and this is what actually improves how they are going to work for their organization. This is what is going to improve their attitude towards that organization. So there is also one school of thought that connects satisfied internal customers with happy external customers. If your internal customers are satisfied, they will keep your external customers also satisfied and happy. So that is why you have to understand the positive work environment is highly important for your satisfied external environment, external customers. So beyond this feel-good psychology, though using the term internal customers may have some tangible benefits for teams who work with both internal and external customers, it can also help them prioritize the problems, right? And this can in turn set correct guidelines and set correct timelines to improve the inter-department communication. So treating everyone as a customer may also encourage employees to take each other just as seriously as they would take a referral or complaint from an external customer. So, you know, I'm sure that by now that we have discussed this, a question that I have just displayed on the screen, it must be arising in your mind that do the negative internal customer experiences affect the external customers also? So let's put a light on this. once you know you determine that you are going to address the customers as internal and external, it's easier to recognize how the former's experience can affect the latter ones, which means how the internal customer's experience is going to affect the external customer's experience. So the case in point is that if your internal customers have a role that faces the external customers, such as in a call center, you know, then it is imperative that the systems those employees rely on for their jobs are resilient and function very easily and effectively. So there are multiple such examples in which, like, especially in service sector, say in case of banks and hotels, where if the functioning of, you know, the technology or the gadgets or the machinery is not actually supporting the employees and keeping them internally satisfied, and they are not going to be able to give that correct delivery to their external customers. They are not able to satisfy the external customers. It's not only their own personal satisfaction, but the kind of working environment that they have. They are not able to render those services at all. So that is why it is highly important in this case to, you know, have a satisfied internal customer so that it can in turn satisfy the external customer. So, like, you know, if any person who's brought in the organization and then he is made to work on obsolete technology or maybe outdated processes and, you know, antiquated technology, then a lot of frustration develops in that staff member. So that experience is likely to replicate when your external customers seek assistance from that person. So, you know, you get a dual frustration in turn. Your internal customer is also unsatisfied, and he is making the external customer also unsatisfied and frustrated. So there is a dual set of frustration of the internal customer and the external customer, which is, of course, not a very good recipe for the success of any organization. And that is why to deliver smooth, intuitive experiences for internal customers actually frees them to provide the same to their external customers. Once, if an organization is giving the internal employees the best possible technology to work on, most satisfied work environment, you know, well satisfied and well conditioned organization will always make their internal customers happy. And then the organization can actually demand 100% efforts from the employees. That now that we are giving you everything that you want, you should give us what we require. And that is why they will work extremely hard to keep your each and every client satisfied. And that is why in service sector, keeping your internal customers satisfied is so important. And that is why any kind of negative experience that your internal employee will have, internal customer will have, that negative experience is going to reflect on your external customers also. Now let's try to find out what are the drawbacks of making each person a customer. You know, that is another very important aspect that I wanted to discuss with you people. So, you know, there are a lot of business experts and sociologists who are aware of the inherent confusion in delineating internal and external customers. Which means, you know, how do you actually apply that the customers are always right? Right? because sometimes a customer might demand something that is out of the need to be actually applied to him, or that is next to impossible for any employee to supply to him or deliver to him. So, you know, there are times when you have to contradict with the ideas of your external customers also. And whenever you are contradicting with your external customers, then the question mark arises whether your customer is always right or not. So, you know, and sometimes, you know, this not only happens to a co-worker or a co-employee who isn't on board with the new company philosophy or the method, but the existing ones also. That I have been working with this organization ever since a very long duration of time, but never has this experience come to me that my customer has demanded something so different from the others, and I just can't satisfy him by offering what he is requiring. What to do? And then the clash occurs between the two people, the internal and the external customer. So the truth is that you may be or may not be able to actually satisfy your customer. And which is why, you know, some people believe that the term internal customer can dilute the urgency around the external customer. So this paradigm shift may actually promote more mediocre performances. That, you know, it's okay. We can't make everybody too satisfied. We can't make our 100% external customers 100% satisfied. Is the organization also keeping us 100% satisfied? So if everyone is a customer, you know, who is the most important one? That is the question. And the answer should be the external customer, right? Because I'm considering that my internal customer is also a customer and the external customer is also a customer. Now, there should be no confusion about this priority that has to be given to any one of them. It is absolutely clear and obvious that the most important one is the external customer. It is highly important for us to keep the external customer extremely satisfied no matter what the conditions are for the internal customers. It is okay for the organization's part to consider you as an internal customer and believe that we are supposed to be, you know, providing you all the benefits so that you can work in the favor of the external customer. But as far as the priorities are concerned, the external customer is obviously the most important one. There's no doubt about it. So, you know, there are a lot of CEOs who actually find more success when they connect with the employees also and the external customers also, or sometimes when they connect the customers, I mean external customers, with the employees. It is more impactful to talk about how their product, it could be anything, say medical devices, time management softwares, bicycle helmets, anything. So how their product is valuable to the customers by saving their lives or maybe by improving their work, than it is to compare how much money the shareholders will get as a result. So many employees in IT customer service and other customer facing roles also support the external customers only. Mindset is that it leads to better alignment across the organization. And you are all trying to serve the singular group of external customers instead of the various internal clients that are spread across your organization or different departments of your organization and the related partners who are supporting the organization. So with this, I hope that I have actually made it absolutely clear that what are the drawbacks of making each person a customer. So Now, there is another part that I wanted to discuss with you in today's session, which is the transcended customer experience. So, you know, one of the tenets of the autonomous digital enterprise is the transcendent customer experience, TCE. And it weighs external and internal customers as equally important. And it sees the external customer experience, CX, and the internal or the employee experience as EX, evolving to, you know, any kind of future state that gives the customers what actually they want, when and where they want it, quickly and seamlessly. Which means that, you know, whatever they require, whatever they need, you know, that should be promptly delivered to them. So in many ways, you know, the future state has been significantly fast-tracked. And this CX and EX have almost blurred into one. That no matter what, whosoever requires it, we have to be prompt and deliver. So that is the latest type of ideology that is surviving today, and which is the transcendent customer experience. So, of course, we have been living through the unfortunate times of the pandemic that has spread, COVID-19, ever since 2020. 2021 is also trapped by the same disease. And we are still maybe expecting a third wave of COVID-19 even in India. So we have seen, you know, that there has been a cultural shift that we have seen in ways of working of the organizations. Suddenly the organizations were brought home and people started working from home. The lecturers had to leave the universities and started lecturing from them, their home, the way I'm doing today. We are taking classes from home. Students are sitting at home and studying since 2 years. So with this, you know, that there has been a total cultural shift. There was this one time those people who were hardcore mall crawlers and shoppers, they were brought down to the pool of digital marketing and online shopping. So that is why, you know, with this 2020 global pandemic putting so many brick and mortar businesses and on-site work arrangements on pause, this CX and EX, you know, they are increasingly being done online from mobile phones, tablets, laptops, and array of different devices. And to address to this, you know, many retailers, businesses, and employers have had to nimbly pivot their thinking and their systems to catch up. Whether that means supporting online ordering and contactless delivery, or maybe telemedicine, or maybe helping a staff set up high-speed internet, VPN, and maybe conferencing tools to do their jobs at home. So it could be anything. But we know that today, because of this, the CX, EX, you know, both the jobs are done at home, online. And that is why this concept has zoned out and it is becoming one blurred vision. And they have actually compiled into one figure. So businesses that immediately shifted gears to adapt to these new processes they have been able to keep their internal and external customers very happy. But those that couldn't do this, they are actually facing huge problems. Some even had to face the problem of closed doors. So this has been actually driven by a marriage of data and journey analytics that actually anticipate and deliver proactively instead of reactively. So there have been, you know, multiple data analytics and journey analytics who were able to understand the need of the hour and the future needs that might arise suddenly. And they were intelligent enough to draw such devices and such technology and such softwares through which people could actually work very easily online and from home. So this transcendent customer experience actually ascribes to the idea of taking the experience to the customers wherever they happen to be, right? Which means wherever the customer is, we will try to give him a good customer online. So this merging of human elements with the technology, no, specifically the artificial intelligence, which we often know as AI, and of course machine learning, which we call as ML. So this, you know, merging of human elements with the technology like AI and ML, which is artificial intelligence, and they are tracking the customer's each and every action, you know, each and every purchase behavior. Like till what level of purchase a customer reached. Say a customer reached and added material to his cart, products to his cart, and at the time of payment, you know, the customer stopped. Maybe his debit card was not working. Maybe he didn't want to pay through debit card. Cash on delivery option was closed because of pandemic. So that is why each and every shopping website now has the support of payment through UPI. And gone are the days now when people used to actually carry cash in their pockets. Everyone is taking payments, right from the vegetable vendors till all the big stores. Everyone is taking UPI payments. This is also an achievement which has been done or created by AI and ML. So this merging of human element with technology has actually enabled a new era of, you know, mobile first and do-it-yourself solutions that have actually empowered their external as well as internal customers. And they can now become an architect of the services and solutions that they need with a simple swipe or just a tap on the screen. You can order anything that will come to your home and get delivered just by the touch of a button, whether it is cooked food, whether it is raw vegetable, groceries, clothes, electronic gadgets, accessories, tires of an automobile car. It could be anything. So this newfound technology has also brought in a lot of speed and convenience to both the internal and the external customers. So what is this speed and convenience doing? It is actually supporting the customers by providing them good speed of working and fast payment methods, easy payment methods, and convenient shopping benefits. Like today, if I go and buy a product from Myntra, it comes, I try it and I don't like it, I can easily file a return. So this newfound speed and this convenience, by return I mean the convenience. Convenience of payments, convenience of returning, return policies, anything like that. Warranties, guarantees that we get. So this convenience, you know, these two things will no doubt have a very far-reaching implication for both internal and external customers as they chart a course towards the future. Right? So all of you have to remember that not only is the arouse of this latest technology with AI and ML has supported the internal customers to provide better services to the external customers, but has also, you know, enhanced the customer experience to a far bigger level. The females who are working from 9 to 5 or sometimes 9 to 7 in their offices and not getting time to even purchase their groceries can on a click of a button select the groceries and get them home in no time and even make payment for them in no time. That too online. Who had thought of this ease 1 decade back? Or not even 1 decade back, 5 years back. Who had thought of this ease? No one. We never knew this could happen. And with the advancement of the technology, we will see that the things are going to be really advanced. And there will be a time period when only specialized professionals are going to hold any kind of good position in any good advantage. So tomorrow is going to be the world of specialists, not the jack of alls. If you want to survive tomorrow and you want to make your position tomorrow, you have to be the specialist of that field, whatever you are working in. Always remember. So with this, we have almost come to an end of this session. Let's quickly once again brush up as to what all we have discussed today. We have discussed the difference between internal customers and external customers, how they are actually different from each other. Then we moved ahead and we discussed what is an external customer, how they are different from the internal customers. Moving ahead, we also discussed how organizations formulate a goal of keeping your external customers depend upon your product and services, repeat their purchases, refer your product and services to another friend or peer, how they give positive reviews and otherwise support your organization as a whole. We also tried to compare the internal and the external customers. After that, we found out whether the negative internal customer experiences actually affect the external customer experiences or not. So, you know, we understood that yes, it is highly important for us to keep our internal customers also very, very satisfied so that their satisfaction will reflect on the way they actually give away the services to their external customers. So their happiness index will reflect on your customer satisfaction level of the external customers. After that, we tried to discuss the drawbacks of making each person a customer. And I tried to introduce you to the, I'm sorry, it is extremely windy today. So I also tried to introduce you to the concept of prioritizing who is more important to us and understanding that the customer, external customer, is of course holding a greater priority because it is upon the external customer on which our revenue actually depends. Then we tried to understand the transcendent customer experience, where we actually understood that, you know, as the speed and convenience of technology will increase, will ultimately increase the competition, not only the competition, but also be very beneficial for the external customers, because that will be something that will make them really very satisfied with their organization. Because when an organization's AI ML is extremely advanced, it can track the correct need and the correct requirement of the employee or of the external customer and deliver him the correct service that he wants. So with this, we have come to an end of today's session. I really hope that you have understood each and every point thoroughly that we have discussed today. And in our further sessions of service marketing, we will be discussing some more detailed topics of service marketing. Meanwhile, this is all from my side for this session. This is Dr. Swati Mishra from International School of Business Management at Suresh Gyanvihar University signing off. Thank you so much for viewing the sessions. If you have any query, I request you to please post your queries in the message box. I would be really happy to answer to your queries. So that's all from my side. Bye-bye. Have a nice day.